We are holy, holy, holy. We are holy, holy, holy. We are holy, holy, holy.
You and me. Yeah.
To Center for Spiritual Living, Parker. Wow, lots of energy this morning, yeah? I love seeing the smiles on your faces this morning as you're hugging each other, feeling the love, sharing the love. If you're new to CSL Parker, welcome especially to you. Please know that whoever you are, wherever you are on your journey, you are loved and welcomed here. So good morning. I'm David Howard. I have the privilege of serving as the minister at this beautiful community, so I'm blessed to be able to do that. You know, I just want to mention one thing. You may have noticed the parking situation. I don't want to call it a situation. The parking out front. You know, last week, I just want to share a little bit about, last week I felt very frustrated about that. And I was kind of in judgment about it. And then I recognized, yeah, I really was sort of like, okay. Because I think I was in sort of fear about it, that if people didn't have a place to park that was easy, they would just go away and not come back. And so that was my fear going on in my own mind. And so today, as I was looking at that, and I know we made some effort to block off some spaces, and I appreciate those of you who are part of that, and know that, please know that you can park there. There's also a parking lot in the back if you need it. But what I recognize today, as I've been focusing on this energy of love, and loving people and loving myself, is that I so was connected to the excitement and the joy and the energy of those children who are out there playing this game. And so it sort of inspired me to get over my little self and really connect with that within myself, this joy and excitement of life, you know? And so who cares if there's no place to park? Let's just be in joy and celebration of that. And so however we need to make that work, we will make that work. And if you're willing to help us next week with trying to create some space, please let us know that. All right, so enough of that. I don't know if you can see the mission and vision today. Let me move it over a little bit so everybody can see it. Because Colleen did such a beautiful job of our altar this morning. Thank you, Colleen, once again. What a beautiful expression of creativity and joy. I love it. So we are, let us say our vision together. We are a vibrant, nurturing, loving community, welcoming and inspiring all on their spiritual path. And our mission is, we foster the experience of oneness, peace, love, and joy through inspiring Sunday services, classes, workshops, and loving service to the community. That's who we are. That's what we're about, right? And thank you for being a part of that. If you are new to us, I'd like to let you know there are welcome packets on the table. There's some over here on the table. I think there's some back there. When you leave, please take one of those. Give us a little bit more information about who we are. And there's also welcome cards over there. If you're new to us, please fill out one of those. We'd love to have a record of your attendance with us today. Also, as you leave, there's a prayer box at the table back there. If you have a prayer request, please fill out a card, place it in the box, and know that it is prayed for and over during the week by our practitioners. The men's and women's groups are both meeting today. Ministry groups are meeting today at 11:30 after service. We do ask that everyone who's willing, so that everybody can attend, help us clean up, put things away, clean up things around here so that everybody will have the opportunity to participate in the men's and women's group. So if you're willing to do that, you might check with Jennifer back here, who might give you some guidance on how to do that and what we need around that. So thank you for your willingness to serve in that way. Next Sunday is our potluck. So if you're planning to come, we'd love to have you come and be a part of that. So bring a dish to share with each other. It's always on the third Sunday of the month. Let's see, I think that's all except we have two announcements today. So I would like to invite Dave Richardson up to talk about a service opportunity, a giving opportunity we have.
Thanks, Dave. Well, I sort of announced this last week, but excuse me, a lot of people probably didn't forget. We got some stuff that was dropped off today. This is for the Parker Task Force Food Bank. We're going to have another hope-for drop-off next weekend, next Sunday. My truck will be parked right in front. If you bring anything, that would be wonderful. They could use whatever you can give. If you haven't got the ability to go and shop and buy, if you just want to put a check into the tithing basket made out to Parker Task Force, that would be wonderful too. They're a great organization. There's lists over here at the sign-up table, the Learning Center table, where you can pick up a list of what they're looking for, as well as a brochure on what they do. It's a great organization, and whatever you can give, a little bit helps a lot. Thank you.
Thanks, Dave. And we have a great class coming up this week, and so I'm going to invite Joe Albers up to tell us a little bit about that.
1 minute, 2 minutes.
2 minutes. So, bottom line is, I had this conversation that you just mentioned with Bob out in the parking lot. I sat there and I said, but look at all these kids, look at the mountain backdrop, look at all this. And this is what this class is all about. This class is learning how to not be out there looking for the wizard to fix everything, right? Politicians included, everybody. And we spend most of our life looking outside when really it's all inside of us. And that's what this class is really all about, is that do you have the courage to get off of that yellow brick road, go inside, and take a look at where is your heart? Where are you connected? Where can you serve yourself best? And that's what we're doing on our Thursday, and we have a special guest in our class. Dr. Vern is going to be in the class with us. So that is a gift beyond the yellow brick road, okay? Beyond Oz. And I think that it's right down the street here at the Creekside Rec Center. It's going to be Thursday from 10 o'clock to noon, and you can still sign up online. And if you can't get to it, show up anyway, okay? Just show up. That's all we have to do for each other, isn't it? And for ourselves. So again, it's this Thursday, and I look forward to seeing you guys. Thank you.
Thanks, Joe.
Thank you, Joe. Appreciate it. Thank you, Joe. We also have practitioners who are in our service today. You'll see the people wearing their stoles. they are here to pray with you, to hold you in consciousness. And so just ask one of them if you'd like prayer after service. They would be more than glad to sit with you. And there's some spaces back here. You could also maybe go in the room in the back if you'd like a little more privacy and quiet. And so we have sort of a newish practitioner with us today. Maren is going to be our practitioner of the day. She's going to share a little bit with us and share a prayer with us. So come on up, Maren.
Thank you, Reverend David. Good morning.
Good morning.
Today I am going to share some wisdom from a book called Ripples of Wisdom by Don Jose Ruiz. That name may sound a little familiar. He is the younger son of Don Miguel Ruiz, whose most famous book is The Four Agreements. And so the Ruiz father and the two brothers have written many, many books, and they are quite wise. They speak from an ancient New Thought teaching called the Toltec Wisdom, which is the ancient wisdom from Mexico. And yay, Mexico, yes. So this book is very sweet, and I would encourage everyone to come take a look at this book. After, with every reading, there's just beautiful pictures and artwork depicting life. And so there's a couple of passages that I'm going to share with you of their wisdom. What is your image of perfection? Where did you acquire that image? Image is the important word here, because that's exactly what it is, an image, an optical illusion. You are perfect. There is nothing to live up to. Accept yourself just as you are today. If you want to make a change, take action. But don't take action to live up to somebody else's expectations. Take action for yourself. That's the best way to succeed. And this is another one. This is the image that comes with it. It is a Toltec prayer. And this one is just really spoke to me. The presence of the infinite is everywhere. It is in every flower, every creature, every breath of air, and most important, it is in you. It is you. Why search for something outside yourself when it is right inside you? When you are living in hell, living in all of your knowledge, or living in darkness, you are unable to see the light that resides within every living being, including you. You are the warmth and the light. You are perfect. Okay, I'm reading a third one. Unconditionally love your beloved and your loved ones, the people you say you love the most. Show them the pure love and acceptance of the divine. Enjoy watching them live their lives, living in love without judgment. Allow them to learn, be, and change with no expectations. Bring heaven to yourself and those around you with the divinity of pure love. Let's pray. And in that breath, in that sweet breath, with the sweet tinkles of music, I am sweetly and gently reminded that love is all there is. God, Buddha, Allah, Yehwa, Adonai. The presence is all that there truly is. It lives and it breathes and it expresses and it loves as me, now and for always. And it lives and breathes and expresses life as you as well. In fact, it lives and breathes and expresses life as every being who is close enough and far enough to hear these words. And so I rest in that knowing that God is living love as and through me now. So I speak this word of truth, that today is a blessed day. Today is a magnificent day. Today is a day that we get to hear the Beloved's voice in a way that we may not have heard it before. It may sound like the music. It may sound like the prayer. It may sound like the laughter and joy of hugging your neighbor. All of it is the same. It is the voice of God expressing life. Knowing that there is no separation, no distinction, all one, all connected in the flow of life. I celebrate the magnificent gift that breath is, the magnificent gift that sunlight is, the magnificent gift that today is. And so as we sit here reveling in this truth, reveling in this love, we allow our hearts to crack open, and through those cracks, our light shines through, healing, blessing, loving and growing our planet and every beating heart on it. And so I sit with gratitude for the love and the joy and the word of God that flows so perfectly through me and as me. I'm grateful for this day. I'm grateful for these blessings. And so I just lovingly and gently release this word into the action of the law, knowing that it was already done so in the heart and mind of God, even before these words passed over my lips. And if you are truly ready to allow your light to shine through, please anchor this prayer with me by saying, "And so it is."
Gratitude before me, gratitude behind me, gratitude to the left of me, gratitude to the right of me, gratitude above me, gratitude below me, gratitude within me. Gratitude before me, gratitude behind me, gratitude to the left of me, gratitude to the right of me, gratitude above me, gratitude below me, gratitude within me, gratitude all around me.
Let's take this opportunity to breathe into that awareness. I'm reminded of Brother David Steindl-Rast, who talks about gratitude being a tree with two branches. One is gratefulness and one is thanksgiving. And the gratefulness that we experience is the gratefulness in our awareness that we are the expression of that divine love, that we are filled to overflowing with that divine energy of love and peace and joy and all that we can imagine that God, source, life to be, expressing in us, through us, as us. And we welcome a greater conscious awareness, a conscious connection in our minds and our hearts and our bodies with that life energy that's living in us and through us and as us, and that life energy that has its life in us, through us, and as us. And in this moment, we experience the great fullness of that awareness. So allow yourself to breathe into that. Feel every cell of your body awakening to that truth. Feel your mind being filled with inspired thoughts, ideas, images that arise from the knowing of that truth, the great fullness of spirit right here, right now. Feel your heart breaking open with great fullness of love just waiting to be given and expressed through you, as you. The great fullness of spirit, of love, of joy, living itself, breathing itself as you. And in that great fullness, we do give thanks. Thanks for all of life as it reveals itself through each other, through the nature, through all creation. And so breathe into that as we go into just a short time in silence. With every breath, invite more and more great full awareness of that which I am, you are. Breathe once again. I'm so grateful. And really take that in as you intone that. I'm so grateful. 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 Feel the energy moving through your heart as you sing that.
I'm so grateful. 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 I'm so grateful.
And breathe that all the way down through the bottom of your feet. Sharing that gratitude with the earth, with Mother Earth, grounding yourself in that spirit and that life and the knowing that you are the great fullness of spirit. And let us proclaim together, and so it is.
That was magic.
Something in your eyes makes me want to lose myself. Makes me want to lose myself in your arms. This feeling lasts the rest of my life. If you knew how lonely my life has been and how low I felt for so long. If you knew I love anyone so much. It feels like home to me. Feels like home to me. Feels like I'm on the way back where I come from.
Not fair to do that to me right before I have to talk, right? Feels like home to me. And isn't that really what it's about? Isn't that really what this life journey is about? Is finding home and coming home. Coming home to who we truly are. And to have, the song is so beautiful, to have people in our lives who reflect that to us. And to have community that reflects that to us. That we are home and that we know who we are. And isn't that what love really is? I think there was a line in the song that said, it feels like I'm back where I belong, right? Back where I belong, back where I come from. And this idea that we're talking about, like last week I talked about the power of love, and I thought, well, I'll move on from that this week and I'll talk about something else. And as I was thinking about it, I was meditating about it, and I really got very clear. Spirit said, you're not done with that. You're not done with that. You're not done with talking about the power of love because you're not done with processing it for yourself. So as one of my great early teachers said to me when she said, you know, if it's going on with me, chances are it's going to be going on with you. And I think we're all in it together, right? And if it's going on with me, I'm going to inflict it upon you, I guess, is maybe a better way to say that. maybe that's the way, I don't know. But this idea of love is, as I'm understanding it now, as I'm connecting with it now, it really, this power of love is a field, a force, an energy in which and from which all is born. All creation is born of love. As I use the same quote I used last week from Ernest Holms, our founder, he said, love is the greatest healing and drawing power on the earth. It is the very reason for being. Love is the sole impulse for creation. No one can swing out into the universal without love, for the whole universe is based on it. The whole universe is based on it. It really gives me a better understanding of when we say God is love. When we use the word God, it is so fraught with many different ideas and connotations and energy from many different perspectives. But when I think about God, the creative life force, the energy that gave us life, that breathes us into being, that beats our hearts, that animates every aspect of creation as the power of love, it's so much easier for me to connect with that than sometimes connecting with the word God, even though I use the word God freely. But when I use the word God, that is really what I mean. That's what I understand it to be. And I believe for most of you, that's what you understand it to be. And what is so powerful about that as I understand that is that that love, that energy of love that created everything, once again, I know I said it last week, created you and created me. You know, we say we are created in the image and likeness of God, of love, if we're created as the image, likeness of love. And Dr. Holmes reminds us in some of his teaching about the Bible is that there are two creation aspects of creation presented in the Hebrew Scriptures in Genesis. That God, I'm going to say love, ideated, it formed in thought, in an idea of all of creation out of itself, and if God, love, formed all of idea of creation out of itself, then must not everything be based in love? So you and I, in our divine idea of our spiritual nature, are love. And this is what really hit me this week. Dr. Holmes talks about, yeah, that is that. But then God, source, love, then formed you into a human being. Formed you into this form. Yes, through evolution, but had this great idea of this human form. And when we understand love as the foundation for beauty and harmony and order and all of the ideas that we associate with love, isn't it amazing the miraculous expression that these bodies are? That we don't have to think about breathing. We don't beat our own hearts. We don't digest our own food. We don't eliminate the things that we don't need. But our bodies are so beautifully designed to work in harmony and order and flow, aren't they? Something we don't even have to think about. It just happens. But what a beautiful connection we have. Because not only that, but we are endowed with conscious reflection, conscious awareness. We can have the understanding of all of that. We can understand that. We can connect with that. And when we do that, I believe what we're doing is bringing the awareness of love. So I want to invite you to do that right now. If you would, just close your eyes. And I want us to connect consciously with the energy of love that moves and breathes and has its life and being in our physical bodies. So as you take a conscious breath, just notice and remember how often the body breathes. Without your thinking about it, just this idea of breath itself that happens naturally. This system of respiration. And feel how that energy of the breath shares this energy, this oxygen, this life force energy, as the heart receives that, the blood receives that, and the heart pumps that energy throughout your entire physical body. This energy, this flow of circulation that moves through the body, nourishing the body, feeding the body, giving this form exactly what it needs without your even thinking about it. Feel how it works in beauty and harmony and order and balance. claim that it works in harmony and order and balance, recovering that, remembering that, allowing that, affirming that, declaring that, all of my systems of this body designed in perfect love work in harmony and order and balance and beauty together. Respiration works with circulation, works with elimination, works with digestion, works with the central nervous system and the skeletal system and the muscular system and all the systems of energy that compose this beautiful, vibrant energy being that I am in this human form. And it is all working in divine order and harmony and balance and flow. And so as you recognize that, as you affirm that, as you declare that, see it, notice happening, notice the divine idea in the mind of God. It is the only idea in the mind of God for that which I am, you are, as these beings in human form. And our opportunity through our power of love, power of our understanding, can grasp that, know that, bless our bodies with the awareness of that. See it happening beautifully, wholly, completely. Yes, we are designed from love. We are born of love. We are love expressed. We are light expressed. Remember, at the very instant that your physical form began to take shape, when the sperm and the ovum came together, there was a spark of light. And that light, that beautiful beginning of your body. So God, source, love, formed you in its own image and likeness as beauty and wonder and flow and harmony and order. And your body is a beautiful expression of that. So as you claim it, and even if you might be feeling something that might be a little bit stiff, a little bit tension, a little bit of blockage in some way, know that as you bring your awareness, as you release it, as you let it go, and as you align to love, as you align to the vibrational frequency of the divine that you are, that love is the power, as Dr. Holmes says, to draw and to attract into your experience all that is needed to support you. We honor medicine. We honor the things of the world. We honor science. We honor all of the expressions of God that show up in our world to support us in knowing and claiming and aligning and attuning these physical forms with the divine idea of love that we are. In our understanding, we claim it. So feel it once again, just moving as your body. Feel everything. See everything working in harmony and order and balance together. And breathe into that as you allow it, as you claim it, as you be it. And let us say together, and so it is. And so love is also expressed as wisdom, as we talked about earlier. And tomorrow we honor Indigenous Peoples Day in this country. And I certainly I'm not an expert on Native Indigenous people, but what I do connect with around that and have learned about that to some extent really is that, you know, the people who walked this land, in this land, this very land that we're on today, you know, are the Indigenous people, the Cheyenne and the Utes and the Arapaho and other Native people, were so connected to the land, to the earth, the Mother Earth, Father Sky. They recognized the spirit in all forms. All animals honor the spirit and the life in all creation. Their rituals, their vision quests and their honoring of that and deep connection with the wisdom of the universe. They didn't rely on these tablets, right? Or our AI or phones or whatever, you know, that we, and what's, I think what we can learn from that is that there is wisdom imbued, love imbued as wisdom in all of creation, all of creation. And that we have the ability to connect with that. It's not up here, it's not knowledge, although knowledge is good, I'm not discounting knowledge, but wisdom is that spot, that place within us. It doesn't happen up here, it happens in here. It's a knowing, a connection with the divine that is expressing through all of creation. And I will speak for myself, but I don't think I'm alone in that, that sometimes I think we've gotten so far removed from nature, from that kind of wisdom, that we may have lost touch with that. I mean, when Scripture tells us that we are given dominion over the earth, it's not talking about having power over to use resources, that it's just for us. I think the wisdom of that is that we are to be in care of the earth, in care of the animals, in care of the land, in care of the air, in care of the water that we all share. And when we're not connected to that, when we're not connected to the spirit of the water, the spirit of the air, the spirit of the land, then we disrespect it. And so, again, I don't mean to be preaching, because I'm just talking to myself. I'm putting a mirror up to myself and reminding us that as we honor the indigenous people of this land, might we connect more consciously with their connection to the earth, their value for the earth and the animals and the resources, and paying attention to and connection with how we can really be connected to it all. I know we have some tree huggers in here. Right? I know we have some tree huggers. So go out and hug a tree. Ask the tree. Really, I'm serious. What do you have to tell me? I like sitting on the rocks and just feeling the energy of the rock and just the stability, it's just the strength of that. So if you have an opportunity today or tomorrow, I invite us to open ourselves up to the wisdom that is all around us. Take your shoes off and walk in the grass while it's still warm. Feel the Mother Earth energy, because that is wisdom. That is wisdom that is here for us to connect with consciously. And we might be surprised at how it informs us. Not just, what am I going to say? I think what I'm getting is that that will inform us of who we are. You know? Not who we think we are, but who we really are. And then lastly, what I want to share that came to me this week is about the power of love as it is a force of giving. It's always expressing. Dr. Holmes says in several places, but in the Science of Mind text, he says, love is the self-givingness of spirit through the desire of life to express itself in terms of creation. The self-givingness of spirit through creation. It is the self-givingness. I like to think of it as the life energy. It is like the life that wants to express through us, because whether it is true or not, we have the idea that we are on the leading edge of evolution, you and I. And we are here, I believe, to co-create a world with love, as love, expressing as love, creating as love, giving love, sharing love, allowing love, and being the very presence of that love through our expressions of love, caring and compassion with each other and with the planet and with all creation. I shared with you last week that Marie gave me a great idea about waking up to love. Ta-da! Ta-da! I'm awake. Ta-da! And so this week, we talked, she called me, and she said, I have a great idea I want to share with you. I said, yeah, what is it? So as the voice of spirit, she said to me, and this is the way I heard it anyway, that she was praying and meditating and asking, you know, what can I do? What can we do? And she heard the voice of God say, well, you need to start a marathon. Organize a marathon. A marathon? I don't run. I'm not a runner. And the voice said, no, a marathon of love. To devote 26 days. Yeah. Well, you know, a marathon is 26 miles. To commit to 26 days of sharing love in some way or other. Can be a card you send to someone, can be a letter you write to someone, can be a phone call to someone expressing love, can be giving, sharing Parker Task Force, giving from that way, giving love, sharing love, but committing 26 days. And I honestly can't think of a better time in our country to be sharing love. You know, it's a little less than 26 days to the election. But if we start today and make the commitment to devote to a marathon of love, to share love, and so it will go, you know, to the election, but I think we're going to need some love after the election, no matter what happens, right? So I'm just inviting us, and thank you, Marie, for giving that to me and for inspiring me around that, and to asking us to commit to 26. Can we commit to 26 days of doing something, some way to allow love to use us? You know? Because I believe that's why we're here. Use me. Oh God, I stand for you. And here I'll abide as you show me all that love can do. Show me all that love can do. And so it is. And so take that in, breathe it in, allow yourself to feel once again the vibrational frequency of love, because it is that which I am, you are. Love, love, love. Recognize you are created in the image and likeness of love. not only in your spiritual divine nature, but in your physical nature as well. Love moves you. Love beats your heart. Love breathes you. Love digests your food. Love brings all of the energy and nourishment to your physical form so that you can be that love in the world. So that together we can co-create with love, as love, being love in the world, a world, a demonstration, a manifestation that is the reflection of love, of wisdom, of understanding, of compassion, of care and kindness. And so we join together right now, right in this moment. I want us to imagine that together we are co-creating this field, this resonant field of love, radiating through us, radiating out from us, radiating out into the world, across this planet, allowing love to rise, to raise the consciousness of all of humanity. Knowing that love is the healing power, love is the attracting power, love is the only power that holds it all. And so in that love, we hold all of those who are affected by violence, all of those who are affected by the weather events that have been happening, all of those who are experiencing some dis-ease, discomfort, imbalance, some struggle in their own life experience. Because what we know is that love is the power that attracts into that any situation all that is needed, because love is the only power that can heal. Love is the only power that can attract. And so we see right now it is done, that all that is needed in those situations is provided. It is already done in spirit. It is already done in love, as love expressing. And so as we align to that, as we claim that, as we open to allow it to be, we know, and we know, and we know, and we know, in our very center of wisdom within us, the power of wisdom as an expression of love, we know it, and we claim it, and we allow it, knowing that the law of love is at work now. And so in that awareness, we release our energy of love. We release all to the expression of love. And we claim it, and we are grateful. And I want to hear us say very loudly, proclaiming together, with confidence, together, let us say, and so it is. Amen. Thank you. And I have forgotten. Every week I forget to invite our practitioners to surround this energy, but they do it anyway. And so that is something we started recently because, it's about giving and sharing and holding the consciousness for each and every one of us. So thank you, practitioners, for all that you do and all that you give. So now is the time in our service where we have that opportunity to give, for share from our good, however that shows up for us, to support this ministry. So I invite you to take what you're going to share. If you have shared in other ways, hold that in your heart as well. And just feel it as expression of love, because that's all it is. That's all it is, how it shows up. So feeling love, knowing that we are only love expressing. We give from love, we receive in love, and we know that we are blessed and together, and so it is.
See, the thing about envy in me comes out of nowhere, hits so hard I can hardly breathe. In the middle of the night when I need sleep, you see, that's the thing about envy. Yeah, the thing about angry in me, strong, then I'm down on my silence should speak. You see, that's the thing about angry. But love lifts you up. I know it's hard sometimes to see it, but it does. Oh, it's the power that will rise up, a well that never dries up, the one and only feeling you can trust. So let it be first, let it be us. Let it be love. Let it be love. Let it be love. Yeah.
Another thing about humility in me. Put myself a little higher than I should be. Forget I'm just a drop in a big old. Little more you, a little less me.
'Cause love lifts you up. I know it's hard sometimes to see it, but it does. Oh, it's the power that will rise up, the will that never dries up, the one and only feeling you can trust. So let it be first, let it be us. You keep making when you feel your heart is done with all its breaking, and all the second chances that you keep taking. Let it be love, it's always enough. The love lifts you up. I know it's hard to see it, but it does. Oh, it's the power that will rise up, a well that never dries up, the one and only feeling you can trust. So let it be first, let it be us, let it be love, it's always enough. Let it be.
Amen and amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. What is that? It is a power that will rise up, a well that never dries up. That's great, isn't it? Oh, I forgot. Let's don't forget.
I got you.
Thank you. So I invite you all to stand, if you're willing and able to do so. And as we breathe into the awareness that love is the only power, the only truth that moves in us, through us, as us, we know that these gifts and offerings today are expressions of that love, manifestations of that love, and we receive them gratefully and we share them joyously. And together, let us say, and so it is. Blessings.
Let's see.
What's now?
We're going to do something different today. We're going to remember that we are the lights.
Ah, I love
that. And the loves, but we'll keep it light. I am a light in this world.
I am a light, I am a light, I am a light in this world, I am a light.
Yes, go out into the world today and let your light shine. Yeah. So it is.